Welcome back everyone. Today I'm going to show you another simple and easy recipe. It is called as chicken shorba salad. Basically it's a very soupy texture chicken curry with potatoes and it's very easy to make. Let's have a look at the ingredients. For chicken shorba salad you would need about 800 grams of chicken that has been washed, cleaned and marinated in salt for about an hour. Then you need about 2 large potatoes diced, 2 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste, 2 medium chopped tomatoes, 2 medium sliced onions, some cilantro and green chilies, Now this is chicken rendered fat, this is optional but it tastes good if you add it in the curry. Along this I am going to also add about 60 ml of canola oil. Now these are the dry spices, 2 tablespoons of red chili powder, Kashmiri red chili powder, 2 tablespoons of coriander powder, 1 tablespoon of cumin powder, 1 teaspoon of garam masala, some salt only for the masalas, and about 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder. The salt is already added in the chicken, so you would not need a lot of salt. You just need a little bit for the spices to go through. And lastly, some kasuri methi or dried fenugreek leaves. This is to enhance the flavor. Now heat 60 ml of canola oil in a heavy bottom pan. Once the oil is heated, add sliced onions and fry them. The onions need to be fried until they are brown or caramelized. That's how you should get a nice deep brown color. This actually enhances the flavor of the curry. Now is the time to add the chicken, which has been marinating for about an hour. And mix them well with the onions, coat them well with the onions. Now mix well so that the onions and chicken become one, so they are beautifully combined. Now goes in the ginger garlic paste. Now fry the chicken with ginger garlic paste for about 2 to 3 minutes or until the raw smell is off. And the chicken changes color to white color as you see in the video. Now is the time to add chopped tomatoes. Add the tomatoes and mix them well. The idea here is to cook the first part of the chicken with the tomatoes juice. Mix them well, cover them and cook for about 4 to 5 minutes. Now after 5 minutes of cooking, the chicken and the tomatoes have released good amount of water in which the chicken is cooking. Now the tomatoes are also soft and tender. Now it's time for the next step. Now add all the dry spices and the chicken render fat and give it a good mix. Now if you're not going to add the rendered fat, you can also replace it with some butter or with some ghee and give it a good mix. We have to cook this for about 5 to 6 minutes covered until you see the oil starts to float. Now it's been 5 minutes, the chicken is already cooking and you can see how beautifully the fat is floating on the top. Now here I'm adding about 900 ml of hot water. Now since, as I mentioned, this is like a shorba salan, a shorba curry, it's more of a soupy texture, so you would have to add more water. If you don't prefer, then you can reduce the amount, or if you want, you can add more amount. Now next goes in the diced potatoes, the best part of the curry actually. Next goes in the chopped cilantro and chopped green chilies. Now green chilies you can add as per your preference. Now give everything a one good mix and cover and cook for about 22 to 25 minutes on medium heat. Now after 25 minutes, your chicken shorba salan is ready. The cooking time may vary based on the kind of pot you're using. Now it's time for the potato test, just to check if it's cooked through. And yes, it is. Now the last part is adding the kasuri methi or the fenugreek leaves. Now give a good mix, turn off the heat, cover and keep for about 10 minutes before serving. You can have chicken shorba salan with pav, with naan, or even with rice. So your curry is ready. If you like the video, if you like the recipe, do give a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't. And thanks for watching.